Hello everyone, this is Rand here again. Another episode of Farming Simulator 2013. And we are playing on the Westbridge Hills map from the Titanium DLC. And we finally got all the corn harvest done. Go back that way. 9, 8, 11, 17, 16, 18, 21, 14, and 15. So, before we get started here, anybody have any guesses on how much corn we actually got from this? Now, I have not looked, so I actually don't know. I know the last number I seen was like 4 million something, so I'm going to say we got 5.25 million. So, if anybody has any guesses, then we're going to start selling it here, too. We're going to set up a course play course. I'm going to probably drive one of the trucks, and we'll have course play driving the other three trucks. May or may not get a couple of the wagons that are involved. I don't think so. We'll see how fast it sells. Maybe we will. But anyway, my guess is 5.25. That's just a guess. So, let's get one of these trucks here. And before I fill the truck up, I will show how much we actually have. Let's see how close I am to being right as well. Let's see, corn. I think that's the end one here. Okay. Hopefully all your guesses are in. Let's take a look. Yeah, I'm not too far off. Probably 5.5 have been closer. 5,405,265,000 corn. And I believe that's liters, so 5,405,265 liters of corn. Wow, that's a little bit of corn. And without further ado, let's sell it. And I should probably check where are we selling it. I think it's still the warehouse, I believe. The warehouse at 646. And if my map is right, that would be the building that is over here. So we'll make, I'll probably just cut straight across this field. Going up through this way here with this flour mill and train stuff here. Seems like the trucks are forever getting stuck there. And for simplicity's sake, I'm just going to cut across the field. Since I'm going to be running multiple trucks here, I don't want them getting tangled up in each other. So I'm going to try to keep this course somewhat separate. Okay, pull them up underneath the spout. Yeah, somewhere about there should be good. Start the course recording. And maybe I should be an outside view. That might give me the best. I think, come around this way. Gotta make sure we don't get on that part there, otherwise it'll probably unload all our corn we just put in there, and that would be bad. And we're going to kind of cut through the middle of the field here. Wow, this full load of corn really cuts down on the speed on this truck. Don't think I ever noticed that before. Of course, we're going uphill back there too, so that might have affected it. And the sell point, if I remember correctly, it's been a while since I've been over here, is behind here. Ah, yes, there we are. Okay, and money's rolling in now. Ooh, that's something I should have done. I should have looked how much money we had before we started. Bummer. Oh well. That's another good question. How much do you think I'll make here? Any guesses out there? How much money we'll make off this? I'm predicting about 2.5 million myself. That depends on the price, though. I'm making the assumption the price is probably going to go down by the time we sell all this. It might not. We might be able to sell it before the price goes down, but I don't think so. I fully expect it'll take us a while to sell all this. Now, those trucks are not my way down there, are they? No, they're not. Good. Like I say, I may or may not get the wagons they're about. I'm thinking not, just because they're going to be slower, and then they're probably going to slow down the trucks as well, because the trucks will get behind them, and that might not be good. Let's back them up a little bit. Hopefully that's in line close enough. Transfer mode, drive the course. Okay, let's grab another one. Oh, what truck do we want to drive? Kind of want to drive the lizard truck, so I think we'll have the Peterbilts here course play. As far as I know, I think these trucks are all about the same speed, so. And I gotta change one thing here first. I'm gonna have to save this. Let's see, sell corn at warehouse. Guess I can't quite fit all of it there. Okay, that's good enough though. Okay, let's load that up. Oop, past it there, sell. Oh, it's gonna be at the bottom. Yep. Last course you create is always at the bottom, so. Okay, and if we start him in here somewhere, he should be able to take off on his own. Okay, speed, maximum speed, I'm gonna say. Actually, we'll just do it from recording, I guess. That might be better. Nope, I want the other one. Load up the same course. Oh, put him in transfer mode first. I'm not sure if that necessarily matters though, because I think if you tell them drive course, it's automatically the first one there is the driver helper, and then he automatically goes into that one, but not 100% sure on that one. So, let's watch how much corn we have now. We should be selling it pretty quick. Each one holds, is it 70,000? So, we'll see how it goes too. Maybe we could buy another truck as well. Seems like a little bit overkill. We got four already, so. Not too bad, though. The wagon there is 50,000, I think. I don't recall what the truck is. I think the Peterbilt trucks there are 50, and these are like 150 or something. We'll just follow behind this guy. I seen one truck coming back already, so. I can definitely tell the weight on this truck is slowing it down. Probably help too if he took the road. That actually might allow him to speed up. Oh, there's something I didn't think of too. There's traffic on that road. That might cause him. Whoa. Got that turn a little too sharp. Traffic might cause a problem with the course play guys. We'll have to see once. Yeah, it is a mite of a tight turn there, I'll have to say that. At least if you take it as tight as what I did. see nobody coming back yet. Yeah, they're filling up over there, though, so they must be working, I would assume. Yeah, you can definitely see on our way back, we're going a whole lot quicker. I mean, getting right up to 50 mile an hour there. And yeah, there goes another truck. We must have missed them, because the lizard should have been in front of that one, so... That's a fairly nice looking interior on this truck, though, I'll have to say. Not better than some of the trucks out there. And fairly good, actually, for even in-game stuff, because... Yeah, a lot of the in-game stuff, I would say, doesn't necessarily have that great of insides either, so... Seems like Giants tried to do a fairly nice job on this equipment here. All the Titanium DLC stuff. Now, we can drive across this because we don't have to worry about it. We're not going to unload. Oh, there comes the other guy back. So I say, we might not be able to run another truck here because we're like, we just filled up and that one's coming back, so. Price is staying about the same so far. I predict, though, by the time we're done, I think the price will have gone down, at least a little bit, anyway, I would think. Okay, we'll try not to smack the building on this turn here. While not running into the back of our other truck here. I think what we may do, well, maybe we'll drive this truck for like 15 minutes or so. Then we'll buy another Peterbilt and trailer. And then we could drive that maybe for the rest of the episode. I'm assuming I can sell this all in an episode, but maybe not. I'm not sure. No idea how long it's going to take to sell this. The only time I've ever done anything this big before is when I did potatoes. And I don't think I even had that many potatoes, so... Yeah, I planted field on Hagenstead. I forget what field it was again. It was one of the big ones. I planted the whole thing in potatoes. Just say I was harvesting potatoes for a while. And then I was selling potatoes for a while. Made good money off it, though. Can't complain about that. May have complained about it while I was doing it, but once the money came in after I was done selling all the potatoes, it was good. These Peterbilt seem to be about the same speed as a lizard, so that's a good thing. I was a little bit concerned about that, one of these trucks being faster or slower. We'd kind of get a pile up behind one or the other one because of that, but looks like we're doing pretty good so far, so. We're down to, we got a million of it sold already. Started at 5.4, now we're down to 4.4. I could, of course, you know, put course play on this guy as well and do something, but I don't know what I would do, so. sneak up beside him here and unload. Yeah, I'm thinking. There we go. Yeah, I'm thinking that didn't work. Oh well. If you have a problem with traffic on that road, I could pull two tractors up there and block that road off. That would solve that problem. Wouldn't be the first time I've done that before. Yeah, maybe once we get down to about 3.4 here, so I'll look at buying another truck. And then maybe we can drive that one for a while. I think that's really the only other truck I have in the game at the moment, so probably should have looked at that. Maybe I could have got some nice trucks in the game. I think I do have some more somewhere, I just don't have them in the game at the moment. That's a good thing these trailers empty nice and fast. I know some of the mods out there, it takes a while for them to empty. Of course, once you open up the bottom of these trailers, I mean, that's a pretty big hole for corn to come out of. I've never seen anybody open one of these all the way up before, though. Usually they just crank them open a little bit. So I'm not sure if, yeah, like I said, I've never seen anybody open these all the way up before, so. Something tells me the systems that handle the corn probably couldn't handle it fast enough if you open these all the way up. Oh, wait a minute. You know, I just happened to think of something. I know why these guys are all going the same speed about it. It's because I've got them on from recording, so it's possible that Peterbilt actually might go faster. Or slower. Probably not slower though, because if he went slower, we would catch up with him. Possibly might go faster though. I'll have to check and see what the price is doing here too. And we almost got a 750,000 here. Nice that white car to stop there for him. So they didn't go crash into the side of the trailer. Yeah, at harvest time, at least around where I live, you'll see the trucks just start piling up when they start harvesting corn and soybeans and all that stuff. Unloading them trucks as fast as they can into the silos and whatever they're doing with it all. I don't think we crashed into him yet there. Came pretty close though. Corn price, yeah, it came down just a tad bit. Surprise, too. I didn't think it would come down that quick or that much. Yeah. I think I might alter my prediction of 2.5 million. Maybe more like a 1.5. Kind of one thing I don't really like about this game, the way they handle their prices. You do something like this, I mean, it just bottoms it out. Doesn't really seem realistic to me, but just seems like that price should not be able to fluctuate that quickly. Or if it does fluctuate that quickly, it should fluctuate back up fairly quickly, which of course it doesn't. Nothing to look at there, that's for sure. That's a little too depressing. Okay, that'll make 2 million there. That's out of the storage here. I was gonna say sold. It's not quite sold yet, but will be shortly. Okay, once we sell this load, I'll load course play up with it, and we'll drive him, and then we'll get it up one more truck. Drive the course and he should take off on its own, on his own. Okay, that's alright, so there's a Peterbilt. Ah, 45,000, okay. And the tipper, I think he was 50,000 as well. Where are we at? Ah, there we go. Corn husker. Don't think I really have any. Well, I got this grain. That's actually got a smaller capacity, though. Yeah, it's got a smaller capacity. Not sure I'd want that one then. We got our corn chopping head here yet from when we bought the bigger one. I just deposited the small one right there. Okay, it's kind of fun to back around into this. Oh, we had it there. Had it there again. There we go. Yeah, I don't like this truck quite as much as I like the Lizard. It tends to jump around a little bit. Not quite as firmly planted on the ground as the Lizard is. Okay. This appears to be a good point to break into the fun that we're having here. Let's see if we can go any faster. I believe that's a Lizard in front of us there. Oh yeah, we can go faster. I could probably change that on the other trucks then. If I set them to maximum speed, I would think they would take off. Oh come on, now we're slowing down. That's something else I don't like about this truck. It seems like it speeds up and slows down. sort of not overtaking them. That was a stop. Is he not? That's weird. Didn't say he was in traffic. Yeah, you notice how we're doing like 50, 53 right now. I bet you we'll slow down here. Yeah, there slows down to 36. Then speeds back up probably to about 50. Yeah, 50 again. Slows down a little bit. Yeah, it's weird how that this truck does that. I'm not sure what's up with that. Even now too, we're going downhill, and it slows down. Yeah, a sudden burst of speed there coming off that hill. How nice. That could cause a crash. A little bit dark on the interior would be nice if it was a little lighter. Of course, maybe now I'm just being picky, but... price of corn is still in the tanks. According to that, we've made a million off this so far. And we're over half done. That's going to make for a long episode. I may have to do some chop-chop on this or speed it up or something. Put the pedal to the metal here. We can pass this guy again. Don't really want to put the other guys in maximum speed because then the lizards probably would not... or they'd get caught up behind the lizards or something. Funny, he doesn't say he's in traffic there. Okay, folks, and what I'll probably do here at this point, I'm going to speed the video up. And we'll be back once we maybe got a load or two left, or most of it sold or something. So, sit back and enjoy the really fast selling of the corn. Well, folks, this isn't quite the last load. We won't be taking the last one, but getting pretty close here. This will be the last full load, so the guy there should be taking the last one. We'll have to tell him to continue, otherwise he won't continue if he's only partially full. Has taken all of it, so we'll tell him to drive now. Let's see, back to us again, and that will be all the corn. We are up to, we might make 2 million, maybe. Let's see, we would have, oh, just this guy in front of us, our load, and then the guy that's behind us with 25. Yeah, no, we won't make, probably make about 1.9 million then. So that makes about 1.8 million, I believe, that we actually made. And last time I checked, yeah, the price still has not gone anywhere. I don't think it'll go much lower. That's like the lowest price I've ever seen. And I'm guessing it's going to stay there a while, too, considering how much you're in traffic. Oh, yeah. They're going to pile up there now that there's nothing to get out of the silos anymore. And if you guys watch the time in the top, in the top right corner there, looks like just a little under an hour to sell 5.4 million corn with about first four trucks and now five trucks. And as you can probably have seen from the high speed, I was passing the other guys quite a bit. Never on this way, but usually on the way to the sell point. I believe that's the guy behind us just sold the last bit of it, so. Yeah, they're all gonna be piled up down here, so. We'll just add our truck to the pile up, I guess. Okay, folks, that will do it then. We will be back in just a minute. I do want to do a little wrap-up for this episode. Ah, yes, there he is. Okay, so we made 1.918... Well, actually, depending on what we had, we made... We now got 1,918,253, so... I'm just going to look, see if this will actually tell us how much we made. It says 1,943. That don't sound right. I think there's some other stuff in there. That's how much it says we made, but I don't think so. Well, you know, it's possible, because that's right, we did buy a truck, so maybe we did make 1.943 million. Probably would have made a lot more if the price would have stayed where it was at, but didn't, so oh well. And we'll be back in just a minute then. Okay, folks, and we're starting on the screen. I just thought I'd show you guys how many hours we have played on this map. 143 hours and 36 minutes, and then we'll just get in here and I'll kind of take a walk around the equipment we got just to show you guys that. I'm not even sure myself how much equipment we got anymore. We got stuff, you know, sitting all over the place, and stuff we haven't used in a while, and we've purchased quite a bit here for this corn harvest too, so. Okay, we're definitely lagging. I'm not sure what that's about. It's probably all the vehicles that I reset here. Yeah, the farm is definitely running a bit poorly. Yeah, so we got our rope, sugar beet harvester, Horsch corn planter, Marshall. Ooh, that's right. That's right, we did buy one of these. I forgot about that one. I think he was parked back behind the barn there for a while. We do have one big case quad track. Our John Deere windrower that has made us a lot of money by mowing grass. Big header, one combine, four blue wagons. Oh yeah, some wheels, pressure washer, more wagons. Our sugar beet equipment. Oh, we're really lagging here. Something's really bad over here. Here's this tractor, the force grit. Potato planter, potato harvester, chisel plow. One truck and a tipper. Tractor hiding behind it. It's our John Deere 7260. Well, that still has, is that manure on there? Looks like manure on there. Not sure what that's about. That's probably the bucket for our Ursus there. Manure spreader. Our Vanderstad corn planter. More wagons. Our smaller combine of the case. That is, oh yes, the smaller header. Yeah, and our disc, our Ford disc, which has one of the, probably the few items that is still the original thing that I have on this map, including the fertilizer spreader. It's probably been with us the longest. I'm just going to say probably, because it could be that fertilizer spreader or the planter there, but this definitely has been with us the longest. That I basically never used this. I think I fixed up a field one time that I accidentally planted in grass. That's about it. Two Buellers. Still the original. And then I believe the rest of the equipment is, oh, we got some over here and some over there. Okay. Yeah, we got a crap load of equipment. Yes, there's our trucks. There's another big combine. Some more big combines. Most of our combine stuff over here looks like. Our 9870 and our S690i. Two of the biggest John Deere combines. Supposed to be where most of the rest of our tractors are, I'm guessing. And the planters, our big planter. Windrower, haven't used that thing much, that's for sure. Fuel tanker. Yeah, corn header and another corn header back there, unloading wagon, chopper. Front end loader. Disc, well, at least I think that, we'll just call it a cultivator. It looks more like a disc. Haven't used much of. Good old Ursus tractor that has been with us quite a while. And another John Deere windrower, stuck on a Ford tractor. Okay, folks, that's pretty much all our equipment. Yeah, like I said, we played 143 hours on this map, so that is a fair whack of hours. Yeah, we ended with $1,918,211, so we'll call it it for episode 100 on this map. We may continue playing a little more. I don't know. We'll see once. But, yep. If folks have any comments or questions, be sure to leave them below. It'll be mostly Season 2 now. So, thanks for watching, and till next time.